to another world stage next, as nations attempt to take a step closer to the Men's World Cup in Qatar in just over a year. And could one of those countries be Libya? They were only allowed back into the international fold in March, following 7 years of isolation. And despite losing 1-0 to Egypt in Cairo on Friday night, their destiny remains in their own hands as they host Egypt on Monday. Let's speak to current Libyan international Mo Bettamer. He's not with the squad at present, but is still hoping to play a part in qualifying. Hiya, Mo.
Hello, how are you? You right?
Oh, yeah, I'm fine, thank you. You could actually be out playing on Monday, is that right?
Yeah, there's a possible chance. Obviously, I've been on standby. I'm just waiting, obviously, too, because apparently one of the strikers picked up a knock. So I'm on my toes here. But obviously, at the moment of time, I'm going towards Stockport County for our away trip, London Euston at the moment. So, yeah.
Wow, it never stops. We should explain, you play for Aldershot at the moment and you're about to get on a train. So you've kindly picked up the phone for us before that. Before you get on a train, maybe a plane, a bus involved too. Anything could happen before Monday.
Exactly, it could be eventful.
they missed you then on Friday, losing to Egypt 1-0. Were you clearly disappointed by it, but sat watching it? Were you encouraged by it?
I have been, to be fair. You know, I think the performance is... you know, I think at the start when we saw the group, it was quite of a, you know, we have got some good teams in the group, you know, Gabon and the likes of Aubameyang, you know, with them, and then we've got obviously Egypt, we've got Mohamed Salah, Hegazi, you know, and you know, well-known players, and I think we've actually, you know, proved ourselves quite well, you know. I think the Libyan league, Libyan players have kind of, you know, stepped up to the plate, and it's been a good campaign so far. And as you said, we've still got destiny in our own hands, and we've got the game coming up in the next few days. And hopefully, you know, we can get a result. You know, regardless of whether I'm playing or not, I think we've got the players to do well.
I can't get my head around the fact you're going to play 90 minutes of football now, could get on a plane and could be playing on Monday as well. What would that mean to you, and if you were to get Libya through?
It's always a proud moment to even just get the call up. Last time when I went and scored on my international debut, it was a feeling that I can never describe to anyone. You know, it was very emotional for me and my parents and my family, you know. Especially when I'm from Benghazi, so the game could be played there, or it will be played there in the next few days. So it's a very, you know, it could be another unreal moment for me. But hopefully, regardless of whether, you know, whether I play or not, I want the country to do well. You know, I think football is a big thing in Libya. You know, it keeps the people kind of, you know, as sport is in the world, football is a big thing, and it keeps that, you know, the people, especially with what's happening politically over there, football is keeping the Libyan people kind of alive, and, you know, on the edge of the sea, and everyone's excited for what's going to happen in the next, obviously, in the World Cup qualifiers.
Gosh, that's even more of a fairy tale for you to be playing in Benghazi too, and would family be there to watch you?
Yeah, at the moment, I think there's no fans usually watching at the stadiums, but you know, just to even be there, and you know, my family have always, you know, you know, even before my granddad passed away a few years ago, you know, he's always, you know, told me about, you know, playing about the national team and what he experienced when he was watching them back in the day, and you know, I'm making them proud, and you know, making my parents proud, and as I said, it's something I've taken huge honour, and I'm really happy, you know, to represent my national team. Hopefully, you know, when the Libyan fans saw, they could see that, you know, I'm playing, you know, for literally the country, and yeah, it's amazing.
I can hear the train announcements in the background. So you go get on that train, Mo. Thank you for delaying getting on for us.
No problem. Thanks for having me.
Oh, an absolute pleasure. Wrap yourself in cotton wool today. Don't get injured, and fingers crossed you get on that plane.
Definitely. Thank you for that.
Take care, Mo. Have a good game. Mo Bettamer, what a story. Off to play football today for Aldershot. Could be on that plane to go represent Libya on Monday in Benghazi. And Mo Bettamer, Libyan international, joining us live on Sports Hour.